everybody, and welcome back to my channel. So it has been a while since I did a makeup video. Myself, my mummy and my daddy are all going to see Mamma Mia 2 tonight, or Mamma Mia, here we go again. I am so excited. So I'm going to be putting on a bit of makeup because I think we're maybe going for a few drinks after. It's payday after all, so I thought, why not? So I thought I'd just film me doing my makeup. I have a new eyeshadow palette. I've actually had this for a couple of weeks now. It has been out ages, but I just love the colours in it, and it's the Revolution, Makeup Revolution Soph palette. Her name is maybe still Soph Does Nails on YouTube. I actually really, really like her. She's so cute, and so cute. Like, she's not like five, Hannah, but this is the packaging. Sorry about the ring light. It's reflective, as you can see, and it has a mirror as well, which, how handy is that? But then these are the colours. They're just stunning, aren't they? So yeah, I'm just gonna do my makeup. No idea what kind of look I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna be doing anything crazy, because like I said, I'm going to the cinema and then for a few drinks with my mummy and daddy. So I don't really need to go anything mental, but anyway, we'll see how we get on. So if you want to sit and talk with me and do makeup, then keep watching. So as usual, I already have my brows done, because nobody needs to see me do my eyebrows, because I'm not even sure how I do them. Like, half the time I'm like, Hannah, they look crap. But yeah, anyway, we're just gonna move on. I'm not gonna do anything too mad with my eyes, so I'm gonna start with my face. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you'll know I absolutely loved the L'Oreal Lumi Magique Primer. It has been discontinued, so I'm using MAC Strobe Cream instead, because it's kind of like similar to it, but like, why would they discontinue such a good product? Like, I mean, I loved it. Oh well. Because, like, they're basically the exact same thing, but like, the other one was obviously a lot cheaper because it was L'Oreal. This is MAC. I am going to actually just say everything that I'm using, because I know some people, when they're doing like get ready with me's, they just link everything down below or list it, but I will probably forget. I know this isn't a makeup tutorial, but pardon me, I probably forget, so I'm just gonna say it as I go as well, because as well it takes 2 seconds. So for foundation, I'm gonna be using the Makeup Forever Ultra HD stick in Y325. I've just scrubbed off my tan, but I kind of feel like I kind of still maybe have like a tiny wee bit of a natural tan from holidays, but I also might not. It was so funny. I wonder, Rachel, if you're watching this is about you. My boyfriend's cousin's girlfriend, who's also just one of my friends, she actually asked me the other night, whenever I had like ultra dark tan on, if it was natural from holidays. And everybody kind of looked at her like, the sun wasn't out, so no. Who's got it? Although it was kind of funny. So I'm just going to be buffing that in with my Morphe M439. I should really know the name of that brush. I've actually been way more into a like natural coverage recently. I was always like a complete full coverage girl, because I suffer quite badly with acne. So I always just wanted to cover everything up, like have it as a mask nearly. Which this will probably still be way more full coverage for some people, but for me, this is quite a light coverage. I'm gonna do a wee bit more on my chin, because that is my problem area. I have an itchy eyebrow. Yeah, my skin has been mental since we came home from Mexico. I don't really know what's going on, but just rolling with it. So I'm just gonna take some of the brush.
more pounce it on.
I've booked to go to London again. If you want me to vlog, let me know. I vlogged the last time and it was really, really fun. Because like, you get to look back at it. I'm using the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer in the shade C1. I'm going to London at the end of August to see Roisin, my friend. Roisin's actually coming home, which, not gonna lie, I'm absolutely buzzing about, because I only ever see her, like, we used to see each other literally every single day, and like all day every day, because we were in all the same classes in school apart from one. Like, we were in the same, we were in the same form class, and then two of our A levels were the same as well. So like, we literally were with each other all the time. We were in choir together, and then it was like, oh my god, where'd she go? She's in London. So yeah, it'll be so good to have her back forever. Maybe not forever, I hope it's forever though. I'm being selfish. I want my friend back. So we're thinking about going to see, where are we going to see? Chicago, because I love it. Selbach Tango is like one of my favorite like theater pieces ever. And also The Lion King, because believe it or not, we have not seen it. And I am a complete Disney freak. Never mind like Disney musical theater, that just is heaven, really. My hair's really pissing me off. So I just use my beauty blender for that, as always. But yeah, I'm so excited to go to London again, because it is my favorite city in, I can't say the whole world, because I've been a few times and I obviously love it. I've been in New York once and I also like fell like deep in love. I'm using the Laura Mercier Loose Translucent Powder. But I just need to go back to New York, don't I? I really do. Shein, take me to New York, please. Hint, hint. But yeah, if anybody has any like different type of things to do in London, let me know, because I'm going for 3 days, and two of the days are traveling days. But traveling means as in like, it's nothing. Like, it's 1 hour in the plane, not even an hour in the plane to London from Belfast. So it's absolutely like, is 100%. But the other day, the middle day, we're going to go to Brighton. Just because I think it's really like really, really close. Is it really, really close? No, that's a lie. It's like an hour or something on the train. I don't know. But we're going to go to Brighton a day because, I don't know, something different. So I'm taking my Charlotte Tilbury, is it Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder in the shade 1 Fair. I'm just kind of setting my whole face and wiping away that bake. I'm so excited to see Mamma Mia. Oh my god, you have no idea. So like I said, I'm going to be using the Makeup Revolution and Soph Extra Spice Palette. So this is like the second one that she's brought out. And I just love the colours. See this colour here? This colour? Oh, and this colour? They're all so nice. But I'm gonna go with something very, very simple, because like I said, I'm just going to the cinema with my mommy and daddy, so I don't need to be too done up or anything, but I suppose why not, Hannah? Why not? So firstly, I'm taking my Morphe M513 brush. Why did I show you the name? This is the brush. And I'm gonna be taking the shade Running Late, which is this one here. I've never used any Makeup Revolution eyeshadows. Ooh. Dash pigmented. Yeah. So what else? Went to see The Incredibles 2. It is really good and is rated very, very highly. on IMDb, which is so funny because it's The Incredibles. But, oh, there's my phone. Yeah, myself and Shane went to see it last week. Was it last week? Yeah. I feel like this video is going to be all over the place because I haven't, like, sat down and just, well, done my makeup in forever. But especially I haven't, like, sat down and, like, filmed and, like, chatted and... It's been a while. It's been a while. I got my hair cut. My hair dyed. Nothing much else to report on, actually. I am so boring. It is ridiculous. So I'm gonna go in with the shade Cheesecake, which is this one right here. Oh, this is on a Zoeva 221 Luxe Soft Crease Brush. We're not having as nice weather here anymore. It was like amazing whenever we came home from holidays, but now it's just kind of, the sun's gone away, unfortunately. I don't know when I'm gonna be putting this video up, but at the minute it is, what day is it? It's Friday and Love Island finishes on Monday. I'm so sad. Shane, on the other hand, is absolutely delighted. We've actually been watching it. When I say we, I mean me, my mummy. No. Me and my sister. Did mummy watch the first one as well? But anyway, we've been watching it since the first one with like Hannah and John and Max and Jess. Who else is in that? A girl, Lauren. Oh, I can't even remember who else was in it. But it was on, it was like so different to what the show is now. Like, it's honestly like a completely different show. Like the feel of it, and like, I think you know you're gonna get like, not that you're not gonna get famous, but like you're gonna have a presence on social media when you come out of that. Whereas the first one, like, they went in not knowing at all. They probably didn't even know if people were gonna watch it. Were Kelly and Lewis in that one? We also actually watched the Celebrity Love Island in like, what was it, 2008 or something, with Callum Best and Bianca Gascoigne. Please. Oh, it's so funny. I actually think that's as like dark, even though it's not dark, as I'm gonna go with my eyes. I'm just gonna bring those colours underneath as well. Tie everything together. So the shades I used were Running Late and Cheesecake. I'm always so scared to bring my eyeshadows too low on my under eye. Love Island at the minute, I think Danny and Jack are still gonna win, but I would just love Laura and Paul to win. I love Laura. I know like friggin' nobody else on the whole planet seems to, but I absolutely adore the girl. I think she goes on the same way that any of us would go on. If we think that we'd be playing it cool, and then like, you're wrong. You would not. Definitely not. Also, she's 29. Like, this is obviously, people are like, why is she on it? It's obviously a last resort for her. Like, oh my god, imagine being single at 29. Like, you think you'd have a husband and children and a house and all that. Like, imagine how scary that is for her. I honestly, I just love her so much. And I think she's so pretty. I seem to be the only one who thinks that as well. Nobody seems to think she's as good looking as I think. I fancy her. Everything about her. Love the girl. Love her. They're very orange and red, aren't they? My eyes look creepily blue. I'm just gonna go in with this shimmer here, and it's called Dreams. If I would get out of the way and I could focus on it. Yeah, so it's kind of like a goldy champagne-y colour. I'm just going to take that on my MAC 239, which is dry, and just swipe it on. Really, I'm not a makeup artist. I'm not even freaking good at makeup, so slap it on, hope for the best, pretty much. Right, I'm just going to stick on some mascara. and then apply glue to my lashes, and then I'm gonna move on and finish my face. This video is gonna be quite quick, I think, but it's also gonna be completely all over the bloody place. So for mascara, I'm using the Collection 2000, what's this called? Lash Surge Mascara. Like, it makes me feel like I might actually not need falsies, but no, I need them. So mascara is well and truly applied, and I'm gonna be applying some glue to my lashes, which are the Lily Lashes that have been worn a million times in the shade Style J Makeup. I look absolutely fucking mental. My God! I think I went a wee bit too warm with my eyes. But anyway, let's see if we can fix this. So I need to bronze up my skin, and I'm going to be using the Urban Decay Beach Bronze in the shade Sunkissed. So I'm getting my eyelash extensions done again to go to London. And I can't wait. Cannot wait. So I'm a picker, so like, my eyelashes that Andrea did the last time that I got for going to Mexico, they would have lasted way longer, but I literally pulled them all off. Like, I'm a psychopath. Like, they would have been so good, but I just was being a psychopath and ripped them all off, which you're not meant to do. But I did anyway. I'm life on the edge. I'm just really trying to bronze up my skin because I am too pale for life. Then I feel like I'm gonna have a bit of a bronzer helmet. Oh well. You know what? It'll have to do. Next, for blusher, I'm gonna be taking the Milani Baked Blush in the shade Luminoso. Of course. Good blush. It's either this or Melba. My MAC that I'm using. I like this as it has a wee bit of luminosity to it, as you would assume by the name. Then for highlight, I have rediscovered this. It's an oldie, but a real goodie. This is the Laura Gilder Baked Gelato Swirl in the shade Gilded Honey, which, like, look already. So good. So beautiful. I literally love this. Like, I didn't stop using this for a reason. I just kind of like found other things. But like, how was I able to put this down? I just don't know. You, and I think you know when. So I made up my mind. Will I ever learn? I don't know how. My daddy's song. I actually think I'm gonna have to revise over all these songs before I go to cinema, because my daddy's the type of person, like, he'll get annoyed at me if I don't know the words, because he'll be thinking I should know them. So I need to revise them tonight before I go, because my mummy was saying, whenever we were breaking the tickets the other night, they have actually been to see Mamma Mia the musical, and she said that, like, people started clapping before the song was over, and like, my daddy would have, like, turned around at them and been like, what are you doing? There's another verse. And like, he was the one to know all the B tracks, and like, he knows everything about ABBA. I mean, everything. So I should really revise the words, or he's gonna kill me. But anyway, moving on to lips before I go into my revision sesh with ABBA. I'm going to be using the 24/7 Glide On Lip Pencil from Urban Decay in the shade Insanity. This has been like my favourite lip combo. It's probably really bad, but I'm really thinking about getting my lips done again. They aren't 100% even yet. Like, they're so much more even than they used to be. Oh my god, if you go back and look at my like first videos, honestly, my lips, I cringe. Like, they're like, none of them, they're not there at all. And then they're so uneven. This is honestly like a massive step up from what they were, but they're still not perfect. And they're not ever gonna be perfect really, but I don't know. Should I not? Again, simply my favorite lipstick of all time, Charlotte Tilbury Kim KW. I was never a pale nude type of girl at all. It was always like a browny nude or a pinky nude, whereas like this is as pale a nude as I personally feel comfortable with. I know there's obviously a lot paler, but this is very pale for me. I kind of like the way this turned out. There's stage where, oh, my mascara's just gonna fly in. I really thought this was a bad choice. So that is the finished look. Just had to check I had no lipstick on my teeth, because I usually do. But I don't, I think I don't. No, I don't. That was a really attractive face. Aren't you glad y'all got to see that? Look at you. But anyway, yeah, that is the finished look. I am off now, like I said, to revise my ABBA songs for tonight. So if you did like this video, then remember to give it a big thumbs up. I just realized I have no rings on or my bracelet, so I feel weird. But yeah, give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because why not? It's free. Just go for it. And hopefully I will see you in my next video. Bye.